teddy bear. And we don't own the rights to this. We're just gonna sing it if we make it through. We were on our way to sing in another town, trying to get there before the sun went down. We had that old CB on channel 19, and there came a little boy's voice on the radio line. He said, "Breaker, breaker 19, is anyone there? Come on back, someone, and talk to Teddy Bear." I picked up the microphone and said, "Talk to me, Teddy Bear." Then a little boy's voice came back on the air. He asked, "Who do we have on that end?" Well, I told him Jake Brake Junkie, and then he began. He said, "I'm not supposed to bother you truckers out there, because my mom says you're busy and to stay off the air. But you see, I get lonely sometimes and it helps to talk, because that's about all I can do. I'm crippled and I can't walk." But I came back and told him to pick up his mic and I would talk to him for as long as he liked. "This was my dad's radio," the little boy said. "But I guess it's mine and mom's now, because daddy's dead. My dad had a wreck about a month ago. He was trying to get home in a blinding snow. My mom has to work now to make ends meet, and I'm not that much help with my two crippled feet. But she says not to worry, we'll be all right. But I hear crying sometimes, late at night. There's one thing that I want more than anything else, you see. But I know you truckers are too busy to be bothered with me. But you see, my dad used to take me for a ride when he was home. But I guess that's all over now, because daddy's gone. And you know, not one driver came on that CB while that little group of boy talked to me. And on my face, tears began to run down as I thought about my loved ones and that old Chi-Town. And he said, Dad was going to take Mom and me with him later this year. I remember him saying, someday this place will even be yours, Teddy Bear. But I know I'll never see him again, so I'll just sit here and keep in touch with all his CB friends." And he said, "Well, Teddy Bear's going to get off the air now and leave you alone, because it's about time for Mama to come home. But you give me a call when you're passing through, and I sure would love to talk to you." I said, "Well, where do you live, my little CB friend?" Then our conversation started all over again. He said, "My house isn't hard to find. I live on Jackson Street, 229. And as I turned that corner, oh, I was really, really shocked. Tractors and trailers and large cars were lined up for nearly three blocks. People from miles around caught Teddy Bear's call, and that little crippled boy was having himself a ball. For as fast as one driver would bring him in, someone else would take him up and take him out again. Oh, you better believe I got my turn to ride Teddy Bear." Then I took him back and set him down in his chair. "Lord, if I never live to see happiness again, I saw it that day in the face of that young man." We took up an offering for him before his mother came home, and then we said our goodbyes and we were gone. And he shook my hand with a mile-long grin and said, "So long, I hope to see you again." Lord, as I drove out to that interstate, tears were in my eyes, and I considered another surprise. "Breaker, breaker 19, a voice came on the air. Just a word of thanks from Mama Teddy Bear. She says, I will always say a special prayer for you, because you just made my little boy's dream come true." And slowly she said, "I'll sign off now," before I start to cry. But may God bless each and every one of you. 10-4, and goodbye. Y'all be safe, be careful, and as always, God bless you in your travels. Peace.